All right, everybody, the Saturday Night Special is coming back. You know, I used to do Saturday Night Specials all the time, and that was really cool. But what happened was, with the pandemic, COVID, all that, it was so hard to get product that it was difficult to put things on special because I couldn't replace it. And so that's why I lately haven't seen much fishing tackle on sale, because it's just been really hard to get. But we are really stocked up on a lot of the Max Lure stuff now. And got a lot of Cripplers. Crippler is one of my favorite lures. And a long time before I was ever doing the show or anything like that, I was catching fish with Cripplers. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the Cripplers on Saturday Night Special. These are awesome, awesome trout lures. So, you know, looking at these, I was trying to think, well, what are, you know, some of my favorite colors? And you know how, like, if you sometimes, like the other day, this somebody walked by me, they had perfume on, and it triggered memories, you know, like it reminded me of something way back in the past. And you know, that's kind of funny that way. Well, it's the same thing, you know, I look at lures like this. I look at these Cripplers, different colors, and it kind of brings back memories of fish I've caught and trips in different places and things. But, you know, so the Crippler goes way, way back. But if I had to pick a few, well, like this one called the Hothead. It's actually the Red Hothead. Oh, they changed the name, I think. I think it was like the Hot Hen or something like that originally. But when Gary Morales first showed me this color, I called, oh, that's the Hothead. Gary, I named it after him, right? But this bright red and the glow white, this is a good one. Caught a lot of fish with these. But before, this is actually one of the newer colors. Before then, this, the old, you know, like fish Shasta Lake a lot, and this kind of black, white, and red. I remember, let's see, the glow shad. This one is just a really good shad imitator. So if you're fishing in a lake with shad, this is a great one. Hey there, come on in.
Hi.
And then one of my all-time favorites would be this Crushed Orange, but I think they changed the name. Now it's Crushed Fire. So anyway, I always called that Crushed Orange. It's what it was before. And you talk about memories, but I've caught a lot of fish on this one. It's brass with that kind of orangey color to it, shallow water, dark days, windy days. I remember like Chess Lake in particular. This was just a killer one. Also brown trout. If I was ever in a lake around brown trout, I definitely want to have this one with me. Of McLeod arm. Just catch a lot of fish on this one. And then, so I got the, you know, the green for the, when the deep fish are down around 50, 60 feet, you know, the green is good. And then when they get deeper than that, the blue, you know, following the light spectrum down, it's blue one. I was just gonna pick five. The frog, you know, especially the higher mountain lakes, the frog pattern is really good. So if I'm gonna pick five lures, that's tough on me, because some of these ultraviolet, this purple ultraviolet one here, I've done really well with. This glow white, that can be a really good one. So it's hard just to pick five, but these are five awesome ones right here that are gonna catch a lot of fish. So, and you know what you might try? What I do, like if you see fish on the locator and you want to catch those fish, well, spin around and get on them. And when you're spinning around the circle like that, going around the fish, so you just say, just simplicity's sake, you got two rods out. If you're going on an inside turn like that, then put one of these Cripplers on the inside rod and a humdinger, which is kind of a speed lure, a little light spoon that's going to go, likes to travel fast, put that on the outside. So when you're spinning around that circle, the Crippler is wobbling kind of down and slowly, and the humdinger speeding up. That's a really good way to go. That's the kind of cool thing about Crippler too, is and why they work so well. I always had, if it was a tough bite, then if, you know, I had a choice between the humdinger and the Crippler, I'd go with the Crippler, because I always felt like the Crippler was a lure that's going to trigger a bite a little more, because it acts like a crippled fish. It has a, you know, that erratic action to it. You can fish behind a dodger or naked, you know, the, you know, dodger's not necessarily necessary with these. You know, if the fish are wanting your lures with dodgers on them, great, like a sling blade, perfect. But don't be afraid to run it naked too. You know, maybe if you got four rods out, the two rods closest to the boat, put dodgers on them, you know, something like a sling blade or a double D dodger, something like that. And then maybe the two rods out the back, run something naked. And sometimes fish want that lot of action and flash and noise and all that, but sometimes they don't. So, but this is a good lure to run naked, or to have that option anyway. And pretty much any speed too. They you know, there's no wrong speed for these really, but they do troll well at slow speeds and have that erratic action. And when you do those S turns and so forth, they're gonna dive and make all kinds of erratic action. That's what makes them so good. And when you're putting your scent in there, you put it right in the little curve right in there, the super gel in there, and it'll stay in there real well. And that's a good way to go. Okay, and also I want to show you my new Kokanee rods here that I've got in. This is the 8 or 9.5 foot version. I did a video on this earlier on YouTube, you can find it. But it's just got that really super limber tip, which is gonna show you everything that's going on with your lure, whether it's working or not, whether a fish is breathing on it or anything, a little piece of grass or something on your lure. You're gonna know that it's not working because this tip is gonna tell you exactly what's going on. But then it's got enough power here, and then it's really powerful down in here to where you can control a bigger fish around your downriggers and around your motor and all that. So 9.5 feet, and it's got the green. I had to prep them with green wraps here on the end because I can't see early in the morning, and I want to see the rod tip really well. That's important. So I had to brighten them up a little bit. And they got the cool handles, that the whole thing turns like that, and real clean, great handles. I love these handles. All Fuji components, made here in Woodland, Washington, just down the street, and built here also. So these are something that I'm really proud of. And they're unique too. You're not gonna find a rod just like this. I'm not aware of any others that are really just like this. I've also got the 8 foot version now, which is very similar. It's just 8 feet long. So you got 2 8-footers out the back, 9.5-footers out the side, so you got a super wide spread. But just another option, a little shorter rod. But these are fantastic. So these are $230 and $225 for the 8-footers, and there's quantity discounts. So for a domestic rod like this, and with the materials these things are made of, that's actually a very good price. So what I could do, boy, I wish I had 10-foot ceilings in this building. Having 8-foot ceilings with 10-foot rods is kind of hard, but I tell you what, if anybody wants to buy a rod, I'll include these 5 cripplers right here. No extra charge. These are definitely 5 of my favorites. It's hard to pick. It's like a box of chocolates, but none of them have that nasty pink stuff in the middle. They're all good. But I'll include these 5 cripplers for you. If you want to pick up a rod, you can order them online or come in the store. You can order online. Now this goes through Tuesday. Saturday night specials go through Tuesday. So if you wanted stuff, you could order it online and then come in later and pick it up, and then you don't have to pay shipping on the rods. The shipping on the cripplers is free, and there's a $3 handling fee on everything. But you can always buy online anything in the store here and then come in the store and pick it up and save on shipping, or just come in the store. So I hope you guys make it in, and hope you guys will please subscribe to the YouTube channel, do some more videos like this, offer you some great deals, and I'd love to see you come in the shop sometime.